A very, very good morning, class 11. So let's start with our today's class. So we are doing the chapter from the book Hornbill, that is Silk Road, written by Nick Middleton. We have already discussed various times about it, how author, he went for the Kora and he had his tourist guide who used to draw the car also. So now finally what happened, author reached to the Dachan area. And there he was not well. He was feeling suffocated. His one of the nostrils got chalked up easily. And he was not able to sleep for the whole night. As he lie down and he used to, and he tried to sleep basically. But unfortunately he was not able to sleep. And he used to sit down. And for the whole night, he suffered the same thing. So next day morning, Stan, who took him to the medical college. So let's try to read about it. We are on page number 79. It says, I lay back down and tried again. Same result. I was in the point of disappearing into the land of nod when something told me not to. I must have been the earth's emergency electrical impulses again. But this was not the same on previous occasions. This time I was on gasping for breath. I was simply not allowed to go to sleep. So said earlier also faced the problem. I was not feeling well, but somehow I was able to breathe one go or the other. But now I was not able to breathe properly, and that's why not able to sleep. Sitting up once more immediately make me feel better. So he thought while sitting up he was feeling more comfortable rather than lying down on the bed. I could breathe freely and my chest felt fine. But as soon as I lay down, my sinuses failed and my chest was all. I tried popping myself upright against the wall. But now I could not manage to relax enough to drop off. I could not put my finger on the reason. But I was afraid to go to sleep. A little voice inside me was saying that if I did, I might never wake up again. So I stayed awake all night. So he said as soon as I lay down, my nose got chalked up again, so I was not able to breathe properly. But as soon as I sat, I felt more relaxed. And I thought if I would lie down, I would not be able to wake up next morning. So he had that fear in his mind. So he tried to be awake the whole night while sitting. Sin took me to the Dachan Medical College. So next day, Sin took him to the Dachan Medical College the following morning. Medical College at Dachan was new and looked like a monastery from the outside with a very solid door that led into a large courtyard. So while looking outside, it seemed that they have reached to some monastery, very huge and a solid door there and the courtyard inside. We found the consulting room, which was dark and cold and occupied by a Tibetan doctor. So there was a Tibetan doctor who wore none of the paraphernalia that I had been expecting. No white coat, he looked like any other Tibetan with a thick pullover and a woolly hat. When I explained my sleepless symptoms and my sudden aversion to lying down, he shot me in a few questions while feeling the veins in my wrist. So as soon as I sat in front of the Tibetan doctor, he was looking like the normal other Tibetan person who wore that woolly hat and the pullover. And he checked my veins with the wrist and I mentioned to him as my symptoms and then he said, it's cold. So he came up with the answer that you are having this cold. You are facing this cold problem. He said, finally through Sin, a cold and the effects on altitude, I will give you something for it. So he said, this is only the cold problem and you are at the altitude. So that's why you are facing these issues. So I'm giving you the medicine. I asked him if he thought I would recover enough to be able to do the Kora. Oh, yes, he said, you will be fine. So author asked from him that, do you really think that I can complete my Kora as I'm not well? So a doctor said, yes, obviously you can complete your Kora. You will be fine soon. You will recover soon. I walked out of the medical college clutching a brown envelope stuffed with 15 screws of paper. So he had the medicine. There was a brown envelope and in that brown envelope, there were 15 different papers in which there were the medicines. I had a 5-day course of Tibetan medicine, which I started right away. So he started his 5-day course medicine there only. I opened an after breakfast package and I found it contained a brown powder that I had to take with hot water. So there was a brown powder, that medicine he required to take with the hot water. It tasted like a cinnamon. The contents of the lunchtime and bedtime packages were less obviously identifiable. Both contained small spherical brown pellets. They look suspiciously like ship down, but of course I took them. So even the lunch and dinner time medicine, it looked like to him that it was a ship down, but he required to take it. So he had taken that medicine. And that night, after his first full day course, like breakfast, lunch and dinner, he slept very soundly, like a log, not a dead man. So he slept very peacefully, like a log piece, but not like a dead man. So here we are covering up right now. So next portion we will cover up in the next class. So I really hope it's clear to you. And if you're having still doubt, you can ask the doubts also. Thank you and God bless you all. And send the worksheet timely. I guess it's very clear to you that how he was a Dutch and he faced a problem. He had symptoms. Was not able to sleep. Next day morning, Sin took him to the Dachan Medical College. There was a Tibetan doctor who gave him the medicine and said, just because you are at altitude and you had a cold, you are suffering this problem, but you would be recovered soon and you would be able to complete Kora. So till here, we are just covering up, and rest we will do it in the next class. Thank you and God bless you all.